Today we're going to be learning to make our own augmented reality filters for Instagram and Facebook, like the ones you see here. We're going to be using SparkAR, a software that lets you design AR effects and publish them to the ever-growing list of cool effects people have come up with. In this video, we're going to be learning to make frame filters, which put your video inside a static image. And then we're going to be making dynamic 3D masks using face tracking. First, you're going to want to download and install Spark using the link in the description. After you've done that, just log into the software using any Facebook account. Then click the box labeled blank project to start a new project. The layout of this software can be intimidating at first, so let me just start out by giving you a short little tour of the interface. First up, the main workspace in the center. This is where all the parts of your filter will appear so you can move them around and edit them. Think of it kind of as a behind the scenes of your filter. On the bottom left is the assets panel. Here you can see all the files that are currently imported in your project. Right above that is the scene panel. Here you can see and select all the components that are in your effect. Over on the right side of the screen is the preview window. This will show you what your effect will come out looking like. And then just to the right of that is the properties panel where you can edit different components of your effect. First, we're going to be looking at how to make a static frame effect. To start, click Add Object and then click Plane. You'll see a square pop up in the workspace and the preview area that can be moved around with the cursor. This plane is essentially a flat attribute added on top of the image recorded by the camera. We'll be using a plane to make a digital frame for the photo. You'll notice that the plane is checkered. This means that there's no texture applied to it, and it is essentially a blank canvas. With plane zero selected, click the plus sign next to materials. This will create a new material in the assets pane. Now, just select Material 0, and then in the right-hand toolbar, click Choose File. You can pick any image file to add as a texture, but we've made one specifically for this example. You can use any image editing software or drawing software to create frames for Spark. You'll see that the rectangle has been replaced by the image we selected. You can now use the top toolbar to adjust the rectangle to the size of the preview window. Now all that's left is to upload and test your filter. We've included a link in the description to a detailed walkthrough on how to publish your effects. Now we're going to be making masks using face tracking. First, you're going to want to click Add Object and then select Face Tracker. This simply adds face tracking capabilities to our effect. Next, click Add Object again and select Face Mesh. This will add a 3D mask shape to our test subject here. You'll notice that like the plane in the last example, the mask has a checkerboard pattern on it. This means it is a blank canvas that we can add textures and other images to. With the Face Mesh selected under the Scene panel, go to the right-hand panel and click the plus sign next to Materials. Then on the left-hand side of the screen, under Assets, select Material 0. Then on the right-hand side of the screen, click Choose File under Texture. In this example, we're using a lizard skin that we made, but you can use any image file. Then you'll see the white material get replaced by the image we selected. And just like that, we have a mask. When you select the material, there are a lot of options in the right-hand panel to change the mask visually, so feel free to mess around and explore. Now you can upload it, test it, and share it with your friends. Finally, to create your own images that can be used with this mask effect, we're including a link in the description to our resource pack. This pack includes an image file called facemesh.png. This is a template that shows you where the different facial features are going to be so you can create your own mask image files. Here we're using a really simple drawing software, but you can use whatever image editing software you want. Use the mesh template to design a mask. And then once you're finished, just delete the mesh template background and save the file. Then just select this image file and add it as a texture to your material. You can do a lot with just the tools we've outlined here, so just have fun exploring the possibilities. Finally, if you're interested in learning more about augmented reality, what SparkAR Studio can do, and how to use it, Spark provides a lot of really helpful guides and tutorials that will get you started in whatever direction you want to go. We put this link in the description as well as a bunch of other helpful links that should get you started. So thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.